The former Minister of Works and Transport appeared before the Commission of Inquiry into allegations of corruption at the Uganda National Roads Authority. Engineer John Nasasira was tasked to explain why firms without adequate capacity were awarded contracts under his watch.
For me, the procurement is the worst. This provision.
He's the procuring entity, he's everything. He's got everything on his laptop and can give himself so many kilometers of roads to maintain.
But where is his provider?
That's the point.
According to the commission, contractors of road projects like Zambale Soroti and Kawempe Kafuluwero mobilized equipment on site but could not begin the works without road designs, which cost government billions of shillings. Nasasira says political issues caused the delay in the construction of the Soroti-Mbale road.
Of course, there was also pressure to get work started. It was getting towards the elections, and the inner government in power wants to account for its manifesto. So you have on one side the political side wanting to achieve their manifesto. You have the technical side delaying.
The commission also asked Nasasira to come clean about the short lifespan of many roads that the authority worked on. The Masakambarara Highway was cited as one of the examples. It developed cracks just 2 years after it was constructed, yet it was meant to have a 15-year lifespan.
The asphalt is cracked almost all the way, but there is 30 kilometers, about 30 kilometers, including Sanga, in some areas where it is intact.
The fault still is really square with the contractor. He has to replace it.
Another matter of contention is land acquisition. In the 1960s, government gazetted land for the construction of a road from Kampala to Jinja and another one from Kampala to Entebbe, and also including the railway lines. However, in the recent past, government continues to pay colossal sums of money to landowners along especially the Entebbe expressway. So the commission asked the minister as to why.
There was a coup, and files started disappearing. When we came back to the ministry, there was no record of that design. There was no record of we even tried to trace it back to the British consultant who had designed the road.
UNRA is in the process of building its capacity to construct roads in order to avoid wastage of public resources and improve accountability.
The major construction work, it will just be a waste of money and something will regret after 10
years. People are not employed, but the Chinese are on the ground. The drivers of the trucks are Chinese. So can we do something as a government policy?
If you give me at the end, sure, a few minutes, we can discuss that.
The commission ordered journalists to leave when Engineer Nasasira was tasked to explain reports of collusion between UNRA officials and Chinese firms. Sudil Biarhanga, NTV.